07, my fellow capsuleers. Today we take a look at the Hurricane, the famous Minmata workhorse. I'm a high and low Zac PvE Care Bear and I'm looking for easy ISK. I'm using the ISK to plex my account and to buy all the stuff I want, and therefore I'm flying advanced and hard missions. Then I sell the story missions for decent ISK. And I'm flying the Hurricane as a kiting ship. So let's have a look at its fitting. Because I fly it as a kiting ship, I'm using strike cannons and I'm using Gistam C-type strike cannons because they are the best at the moment. So cold, we have 573 DPS. Let's make it hot and take a look now. So hot, it's up to 894 DPS, which is pretty decent. As you can see, the range of our strike cannons is 68 kilometers. And if we make this hot, we are up to 97 kilometers range. We also fit a Stasis Webifier and a Warp Scrambler, so if there are any warp disrupting or warp scrambling frigates in the mission, we can slow them down so we can hit them, but normally you are so far from the enemy ships that you can kill them before they can reach you. Therefore we fit a target painter to mark our targets at long distances. Then we fit a medium afterburner to have range control, which is very important for a kiting ship. I also fit two gyro stabilizers for more DPS and an invu field for a little bit more tanking. We won't need it that much, but you can see we're at the limit of our power grid, so an invu field is a good decision. Then we fit a tracking computer for more range. Let's have a look at the rigs. It's not a huge difference if you fit tier 1, tier 2 or tier 3 rigs. If you have the ISK, buy the high level rigs, but the low level rigs will also do their job. I'm fitting a burst aerator, an ambit extension, a collision accelerator, and because I'm a Care Bear, I'm fitting warp core optimizers two times just to have more warp core stability. And I'm fitting a semiconductor memory cell for more capacitor. Let's talk about the playstyle. I warp into the advanced and hard missions at 60 km and then I'm orbiting the battlecruiser or the battleship in the mission at 62 kilometers. Then I'm killing all the ships from small to large. That's the way I do it, and it's a very safe, easy and effective way to do advanced and hard missions. Let's have a look at my skills. I'm not a complete PvE focused pilot, so my cannon skills are not the highest. So I have medium cannon operation 5 and advanced medium cannon operation 4, and I have medium cannon upgrades 5, 5, 3. The medium cannon upgrades are more important because they give you more range, and for a kiting ship range is more important than damage. These skills are good enough to finish all advanced and hard missions safe and fast. Okay, so if you have any questions to the Hurricane, the playstyle or the skills, just write to the comments. I wish you all the best. 07 and fly safe and have a lot of fun at Eve Echoes.